الذي يعلم أن أخاه هو جسده فإنه يسعى إلى إصلاح جسده إذا وجد الخلل.
The one who knows that his brother is like his own body, then he would hasten to rectify and fix and mend his brother if he found any mistake or deficiency in him.
حتى تعم العافية في جسده.
So that he would have health and wellness in his body.
حتى ينعم بالنعمة.
So he can taste and enjoy the blessing.
لأنه لا يستطيع أن ينعم بالنعمة والعافية وفي جسده مرض.
Because a person, he's not able to take or enjoy the blessing and the wellness while he has a sickness in his body.
ولذلك مثل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ليس بالجسد فقط بل في الجسد إذا اشتكى.
And because of this, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he didn't make the example of the body by itself, but rather the body whenever it is complaining from pain.
قال إذا اشتكى منه عضو تداعى له سائر الجسد بالسهر والحمى. يعني أن هذا العضو ولو كان صغيرا لو كان سن يقولون يعني العامة يقولون مرض أو وجع الأسنان وجع الأسنان يجيب الجنان يأتي بالجنان يعني لو سن واحدة فقط تؤذيك ما تستطيع تقول الله يعينه هذا السن الله يعينه أنا بنام وأرتاح وأمشي في طريقي وهو الله يعينه على نفسه لا أنت ما لا تنام ولا تهنى بطعام وتعم أيضا الحمى للجسد والسهر أيضا ما تستطيع فتكون مريضا لمرضه هكذا تكون مريضا لمرض أخيك وحزينا لما يهمه وما يحزنه وما أيضا ينزل عليه من الآفات وكذلك ما عنده من الأخطاء فإنك تغتم لذلك وتسعى إلى إصلاح جسدك الذي هو أخوك وكيف تنال هذا الشرف العظيم أن يكون صلاح أخيك على يديك. نعم.
So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned the example of the body is whenever it experiences pain, that the rest of the body reacts with that. The rest of the body reacts with that pain. So it's like no matter how small it was, whether it's something small in the body, the smallest organ of the body, then the whole rest of the body experiences from that pain. Even, for example, whenever it's one small tooth is hurting, then you'll find that the whole body will be in pain. And that you can't, this type of person who has a tooth pain, that his whole body will react and he will find excruciating pain, that because of that one little tooth, the rest of the tooth can't help or nothing can help him and it will affect his whole body. He can't sleep, he can't eat, he can't do anything, his whole body will be in pain. And this is the example of, he can't write, he will not be able to function because of one tooth. Because of one tooth, and this is the example the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he made between the believers. So if you see your brother and he has a calamity or he has a sickness, he will respond to that, and he will try to help that and try to fix that. In the same manner, the whole rest of the body responds to the tooth, and it'll have a fever and it will not be able to sleep at night. It's affected and it reacts accordingly. So this is the way of a believer. That if he sees a disease or a sickness in his brother, he will act accordingly and he will try to help him in that and he will feel his pain. And likewise, even if it was not like, for example, a sickness, but rather he had mistakes. If his brother he had mistakes, likewise, he's seen his brother make a mistake and did something wrong. He would react to that and he would try to fix that because it's like one body. And he will act in a manner in order to help remove that and to rectify that mistake, not to increase it. So how about for somebody who has the great honor of being a means to rectify the errors of his brother? This is something that has a great status and rank. To be from those who hasten to fix, to rectify the mistakes the errors of his brother. And he liked this narration.
كنت تمشي في طريق ثم سقطت في هذا الطريق.
You're walking in a path and then you fell in the path, on the street.
أول ما تفعل ماذا؟
First thing you do is what?
تنظر هل أحد رأك؟
You look around. Did anybody see you?
فإذا ما رأك أحد قلت الحمد لله.
If nobody saw you, you say الحمد لله.
لكنك تفرح بسقوط أخيك.
But you laugh if you find your brother falling.
وهذا دليل على نقص الإيمان.
This is a proof for the deficiency in إيمان.
المفروض تفرح أنك تسعى في إصلاحه.
What is required, an obligation, is that you hasten and are diligent to rectify him.
وأن ما في أحد رأى خطأه إلا أنت. لأنك ستر له.
And to make sure that nobody sees his mistake except for you, meaning that you are a veil for him and a cover.
تسعى في نصحه ليس في فضحه.
You hasten to advise him, not to expose him.
هكذا تعرف هل أنت مؤمن.
This is how you know if you're a believer.
أما إذا كنت تفرح بسقوط الناس وبأخطائهم فإنك تكون ناقص الإيمان.
But as for the one, if you hasten and you're diligent trying to, and you laugh and you rejoice at the failures or the faults of others when they fall, then and you try to make them fall, then this is a deficiency in faith.
وقبل أن يذهب ينصحه لعله يخبر جميع الناس أنه سيذهب ينصحه.
And then before this type of person, before he goes to so that he says to advise him, he'll tell all the people that he's going to advise him.
ويفرح بالمصيبة تصيب إخوانه.
And he'll laugh at a calamity that befalls his brother, and he'll rejoice about that.
يقول أيوب بن أبي تميم السختياني رحمه الله إني لا أسمع بالرجل من أهل السنة يموت فكأنما أفقد بعض أعضائي.
And it's been narrated from Ayyub al-Sakhtiyani, rahimahullah ta'ala, that he would hear about a man and from the Sunnah, people of the Sunnah, and he would die, and he would feel like he lost a body part.
بل جاء عنه أنه يقول إني لا أسمع بالرجل من أهل السنة في المشرق أو المغرب فأحب أن يصله سلامي.
Rather, it's been narrated from him that he would say, that I would hear about a man from the people of the Sunnah in the East or the West, and I would really hope that I could give him salam, that my salam would reach him.
وهو لا يعرفه.
And he doesn't even know him.
كل ذلك لأنه تجمعه به الحب في الله عز وجل.
All of this because what it brings them together? Love for the sake of Allah.
قال تداعى له سائر الجسد.
He said the whole rest of the body responds to that pain.
بالسهر والحمى
by wakefulness and fever.